Hello, I'm Mr. Arniger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism and real Islam. Here I'm going to give you my disposition on circumcision. You see, many people are getting circumcised. They are from Africa, they are white people, Europeans, black people, all type of people are getting circumcised. But I lived in Africa, in Ghana, for 14 years. And there the people had tribal marks on their faces. Some were one cut, some were two, some were face full of cuts. These are tribal marks to recognize the person that he come from this tribe. No one else can have that tribal mark except born in that tribe. So anybody who gets that tribal mark, that means he renounces his own father and gets a new father. How can you get a new father? So such a person become a self-made bastard. He became bastard of his own foolishness. And Jesus has described these bastards in Matthew 19. Some eunuchs were born of the womb of the woman. They are the bastards born of the prostitutes. They are not allowed to marry. And some eunuchs were made by men, like this circumcision, changing the father, becoming bastard. And some became eunuchs for the royal kingdom of God. That means they renounced their tribal identity altogether to become purely spiritual and take to wilderness as sadhus do. Sadhus don't have a, if you ask them tribe, they say we left the world, we have no tribe now. Purely spiritual. But if you ask them, in which tribe our father gave you the birth, then they tell you. Otherwise, if you ask them simple, what is your tribe? They say, no, we don't have tribes in spirituality. That's why they live in wilderness. Because the spiritual things are not bound by the rituals are these letters of the law. They are above law. So that's why they are sometimes naked. They don't put anything on. And they do whatever they like. But so far they are keep away from the public where they are bound by the law. No trouble. So here I'm doing the circumcision, which is a tribal mark of Abraham to Isaac only. When Ishmael was born, Abraham did not give him any circumcision. When Isaac was born, then he gave him this tribal mark of circumcision. He got himself circumcised and he also circumcised Isaac. And the Isaac being the real son of Abraham, so he had the right over his property and not the one born of the concubine. So that's why Abraham took Ishmael and Hagar and put them outside the boundary of the promised land, that they cannot have any part of my property. So promised land belonged to Isaac and his people. Now they were making the circumcision, they were doing it, putting the mark one after the other, until Christ Jesus came. When they were sitting in the temple, and some Gentile came, because this temple was the only one in the world which had the temple of God as well, that was had a curtain around it. holiest of holy. And through his word, Jesus torn the curtain from top to bottom, from chief rabbi to the village rabbi, out you go. Now you can have direct approach to God. So, when these people used to come and visit this holiest of holy place in the world, and they see the Jews sitting over there with the shawl and all that thing, you know, around them, and singing and all that, doing rituals, somewhat tempted, hey, let's also be one of them, you know. And the Jews, they were very hostile. They had divided the forecourt, that's the temple of Yahweh, the forecourt where the traders were selling their goods, you know, that belonged to Yahweh, the heavenly father of Jesus. That's why his name is Yeshua, Yah from Yahweh, and Shoah mean Adam, are the firstborn of Yahweh, second Adam. Mary was the surrogate mother of Jesus, and Joseph the foster father. And because they had made his house, father's house, heavenly father's house of Yahweh, the outer one, a den of robbers, traders, that is why he took a whip and threw them out in the name of Yahweh. But in the name of Elohim, or in the name of Christ, he preached, if somebody hit you on one cheek, present the other, just the opposite. Because the nature of Yahweh and Elohim, they are two different nature, opposite to each other. So that's why you have to kill your ego. Yahweh boost your ego, whereas the Elohim subdues your ego, opposite, and boost your spirituality of love and service to humanity without any regard to the color of the skin or anything. And this is called agape, unconditional love. Without love, you cannot preach gospel, because you don't know our real Father, God, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, same thing. So circumcision, you know, those people who are sitting in front of the and the other Gentiles, they used to make them sit behind, and they were sitting in the forecourt, that dividing it, you know, that means in the name of Adam or in the name of Yahweh, they were separating them, jealous and revengeful, and they were thinking they are the ego. Ego is the one which is boosted in the once born people. So some people who wanted to sit in the front, you know, then they will tell them they have occupied the temple. You know, temple is for everyone. It's not for one tribe, every tribe. But they had occupied the temple and they made their own rules, own divisions. And if somebody wanted to sit in the front row, then he had to get himself circumcised. So they made a business out of it. That's why Jesus said they will go a long, long way to catch a prey. And when they catch a prey, they put a millstone of rituals around his neck, which they themselves cannot carry. So they circumcise the person, whether he was Gentile or anyone, because these people of the Isaac, they are customary to be circumcised. It was their right to be circumcised because it's their tribal mark, but not the tribal mark of the Gentile. They come from, say, Aryan race. Aryan race is quite different from Semitic race. Negro race is quite different from Semitic race. So how can they get circumcised and become the sons of Isaac? No way. But they were doing it. And that's why, you know, even Paul bring a person to them for circumcision to prove that to everyone. Paul was of highly of the fourth spiritual state, the highest one. He had the very Spirit of God, Holy Spirit with capital S, even to tell us, you know, that what the malpractices they were doing, and they were happy to circumcise him and get money out of him. Cheating. And that's why they did not say anything to Paul, because he was bringing their business, but the people from the East, when they went there, they caused problem to the Paul and uproar. Because East is a more spiritual place, you know, East. That's why it's called East, sunrise. That is, the light rises over there, greatest light. That's why Jesus said, as the lightning strike in the East, it is in the East, it is striking there. But it doesn't flash there because people are greedy there. And flashes towards the West, so shall be coming Son of Man. That was Christ Nanak in India. So that's why this holiest of holy temple was destroyed in 70 AD. And they tried to rebuild it 2-3 times. And fire came from the foundation and made them to run away. Because you can't have two temples of God, only one. And one was there, and Jesus, because they killed Jesus, an innocent man. So, where the second coming of Christ came up in the name of Nanak, so the temple was built in the Punjab, India, but they have put gold on it. What gold has to do with God is a very, very corrupt place. That's why lightning is there, is striking there, but it can't flash there because people's heart are dirty. So much so that we have the one true throne called Akal Takht is dedicated to the apostles. These Khatris who were the kings and emperors of darkness, remember, people of Judah tribe, they are just princes. Judah Iscariot was a prince of darkness. In India, we are Khatris of kings and emperors of darkness. And even the Christ himself was locked out from the temple. When Tegh Bahadur went there, the last Christ on earth, they locked the door and told him, get lost. That is why he went to Patna. Over there, then he preached gospel. When apostles were organized by Royal King Gobind Rai Ji, by baptism, in which the head of the five was beheaded on stage, then head of one, torso of the other was sown, made alive through his word. So when that apostle was sent there to take over their seat in Akal Takht, they were thrown out and they put a camp outside. And they today over there are sitting monkeys, super donkeys. They carry swords. Soul is not allowed into that complex, because that Akal Takht is for apostles who apply the double-edged sword of his word, and not this sword made of steel that is for Khalsas of third community. Royal King Gobind Singh, he never entered that complex because the compatibility of Sikh and Khalsa is not there. They are opposite to each other. Khalsa serves No, sorry. Sikh serves, Paiknaya was serving, Khalsa was cutting the heads of the enemy, of the sons of Satan. Opposite. But the Sikh and the apostles, they are compatible. So this place is for them, not for Khalsas or his anybody with the sword bearing. No weapon should be allowed into that one. However, coming back to circumcision. So these Jewish people, they were very clever. For the sake of money, they were circumcising Gentiles. And when John the Baptist came, he baptized only the Jewish men in the name of Abraham, because the Jewish people had become a people of Judah tribe. They started Judaism to Jew, and they became Jew outwardly, saying bye-bye to their tribal father, Judah. So this is a tribal self, not religious self. A Jew is one who is inwardly, not outwardly. So when they became Jew outwardly, then they renounced their tribal Judah tribe, and they became super bastard fanatic devils. John 8 verse 44. That's why Christ Jesus told them, and they took stones to hit him, kill him. And since then, Jesus was not going alone. So they became his staunch enemies for just telling the first basic truth. Now Jesus took Thomas on aside and told him three things. And then the other apostle said, hey, what he has told you? If I tell you the first one, you will take stones and hit me. And that was that first become sons of man. A Jew is one who is inwardly, not outwardly. When you become Jew outwardly, you become super bastard. If you tell the people that they are super bastard, they will take stone and kill you. They did to Angel Stephen, the first martyr. Angel Stephen was baptizing Jewish men in the name of Abraham. And the temple priest was not happy to mention the name of Abraham. They wanted nothing to do with Abraham. They wanted Jew outwardly. And so they were not happy that Stephen was mentioning doing it in the name of Abraham as John the Baptist was doing. And that's why John the Baptist called the temple priest the brood of vipers, because this sectarian color given to the physical body causes sectarian riots in which thousands of people die. So they are brood of vipers creating sectarian riots. There's much more I can tell you deeper, but here we are talking another topic. So people who are circumcised, and Stephen, when he went to the temple, he was called by the Sanhedrin to come and answer questions. So he went there and he praised, told them, our Abraham was a noble man. Don't make fake sons of Abraham through circumcision. And they were grinding their teeth and all that because that was their business. And he was stifling their business. They were not happy, so they took him outside and killed him. Now when these Jews enter the fold of Muhammad, they not only bring in the circumcision, they also bring in kosher, which is they call halal, the same thing. So they made the Gentile of Ishmael, who was not circumcised, also super bastards, because Gentile of Ishmael, when they took the circumcision, they became the sons of Isaac. But Isaac is now wasn't their father. Ishmael was their father. So by renouncing their own tribal father, they became super bastard fanatic devils. And that's what they are creating in Pakistan, India. La illa mean, I have forgiven, I have thrown away my tribal father illa. The real Islam is ba illa. First be sons of man, of this tribal father, then you will be sons of Allah. But this is ba, this is la illa. La illa mean no tribal father. People have born in tribal home, they have their tribal father. They say, no, no, don't. When you go there to Hajj, that's what they do nowadays. They tell the people not to mention, put their surname behind their names. They become super bastards. And they are creating those super bastards, no fanatic. And they will fight with and kill these Jewish people. It's their own creation. And when atomic war comes, they will be the one, they will bombard them. They will be killing them. Iran, India, Pakistan, all these countries with circumcised people, they will kill them. They will bombard them. Then who is to be blamed? who is to be blamed? The Jews themselves are to be blamed, isn't it? That is why Christ Nanak said, Dadda dosh na dijiye, dosh karmi apneya, jo main kiya so main paya, dosh na dijiye avar jana. That means whatever I have sown, I have reaped, I cannot blame a third person. So you can see, this is dark age, Kalju. You do this way, you get the other way. In the same age, you are paid the reward of your karma. So here is something I have written. Circumcision is the tribal mark of Abraham to Isaac only, and not to Ishmael or the Gentile. Anyone who is not the seed of Abraham and gets circumcised, a seed of Isaac, you know, because Abraham also got himself circumcised after that one, and gets himself circumcised, he renounces his own tribal father in favor of a Semite Isaac. So if the Aryans are circumcised, then they by renouncing their own tribal fathers become super bastard fanatic devils. John 8 verse 44. Khudah, the creator Yahweh, you know, has Yahweh is in Hebrew, in Arabic it is called Khudah. The Qudrat, nature, belongs to Khudah. Noor Allah da, Qudrat Khudai di. That means Noor, the light inside us, is of Allah, Parbrahm, or Elohim. While the nature, this one, is of Khudah, or Yahweh, or Brahma. Whatever you see with these two naked eyes belong to Brahma, or to Yahweh, the creator of male and female. Khudah is the perfect artist, and if circumcision was needed, then Yahweh would have got it done in the womb of our mothers. His art is perfect, and these tribal marks in Africa are for the tribal identity, so that they, by becoming the sons of Adam in tribes, may live in peace and harmony. Tribal people always live in peace and harmony. There are some skirmishes due to boundary and this and because this, all this division of the land is based upon tribes. One house, my house, your house. Always, of course, you have boundary problem, you know, they get settled quick. But sectarian, you know, they are on a global basis and people kill each other in thousands and millions, as happened during the partition of India. Many died. So ask the circumcised men, are they of the Semitic race or self-made, super busted, fanatic devils? So you can see what Stephen warned them against, and it is coming true. So our Father God blesses you.